Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn what is map struct and why we need to use map struct in our Spring Boot application. And the main purpose of using map struct is to convert our beans into another bean type. Like if we want to convert our entity bean into DTO, then we can use map struct. So mainly map struct is Java beans mapping easy way, and map struct is a code generator that greatly simplify the implementation of mapping between Java types. So mainly the map struct is a Java based code generation library that automates the process of mapping between Java beans, and it generates type safe mapping code at compile time, so eliminating the need for manual mapping and improve the performance of our application. And why we need map struct? Because in contrast to other mapping framework, map struct generate beans mapping at compile time, so which ensure the performance of our application. And with map struct, we only need to create the interface and the library will automatically generate the implementation code. And why we use Lombok with map struct? Because Lombok is another popular Java library that helps to reduce boilerplate code by automatically generating getter, setter, equals, hash code and other methods. When we use in conjunction with map struct, Lombok can further simplify the mapping code by eliminating the need to write constructor, getter, setter for the mapped classes. So okay, let's see in the code how we can use map struct and Lombok in our Spring Boot application. Because in our application you will notice a lot of boilerplate code to converting one bean into another bean, another POJO class. Like here is employee entity, and we are sending the request in employee DTO object, and after that we are getting the object from employee DTO we need to convert into employee entity. After that we can perform save operation. So here we can see lots of lines of codes we need to write to convert one POJO into another POJO. So that is the problem that resolved by map struct. If we are using map struct, then we no need to write the mapping code between two model classes. So we just need to create one interface and library will automatically generate the implementation code for mapping. So here we can see, here we have employee entity and employee DTO, and we need to convert employee DTO into employee entity while saving the object into database. And at the time of getting record from DB, we will get entity from database, then we need to convert into employee DTO for response object. And DTO is also a design pattern, and we need to use in every request and response. As we saw, why we need to use DTO if we have already entity model? Because when we will fetch the record from DB, so we will get the record in our entity class. But if we don't want to show all the properties that we are fetching from DB and we want to show only some specific property or some specific field that we are fetching from our table, then we can use employee DTO, and inside employee DTO only we can define that properties that we want to show to our client. So that's purpose we need to use employee DTO and employee entity both. So let's see in the code how we can use map struct and Lombok. So here we can see I have created one employee controller, and inside employee controller I have created three APIs. So one is used to get all employee, and second arrest endpoint is used to create employee, so we can add employee using post mapping, and third rest endpoint is used to delete the employee. So if I will go to this implementation, so here we can see inside get employee we are just hitting to repository find all method, and we are getting response from our database. After that we are just converting our entity into DTO class because our response type is list of employee DTO. So if I will go here, so we need to write these types lines of code to convert our DTO, our entity class into DTO class. So here we can see we need to write 7 or 8 lines of code to convert one object into another object. But if we are using math struct, then we need to write only one line of code. So for this, we will check for like this, we can check for add employee. If I will go to add employee, we are using to add employee in our database. So once we will get the request in the form of employee DTO object, after that we need to convert this employee DTO into employee entity object, because we can save operation with the help of employee entity object. So once the employee entity object will be saved into DB, we will get response as employee entity, but our response type is employee DTO, then we again need to convert into employee DTO. So here we need to write lots of lines of code and it's boilerplate code. So we can remove these lines of code with the help of MathStruct library. So okay, let's start to add MathStruct code. So here I will create, so first I will go to our pom.xml, what dependency we need to add. So here we can see inside our pom.xml I have added 2 dependency, one for Lombok and second for MathStruct. So here I have defined the MathStruct version 1.5.5 final, and project Lombok version I have added 1.18, and one is Lombok MathStruct binding version that I have added 0.2.0. So in dependency we can see I have added 2 dependency, one is project Lombok and second is MathStruct. Because in our Spring Boot application, that is a common task to convert our entity into DTO in every Spring Boot application, we can see. So after adding these 2 dependency, we need to add one plugin to configure MathStruct to with Lombok. We need to add this plugin. So here I have added one plugin, that is Lombok MathStruct binding plugin. So this plugin will be used to generate the mapping correctly using MathStruct, while also using Lombok requires an extra step of configuration. So if we are not adding this plugin, so it will not generate correctly mapping. So we also need to add this plugin up to here. That is Lombok MathStruct binding plugin. So we need to add this also. So after adding our dependency in pom.xml, we will go here in our employee controller class back, and now here we need to create one more package. So inside this package we will just create one interface. So first I will create mapper package, and inside mapper package I will just create new Java class, that is employee mapper. We can give any name, employee mapper. So this will be the interface. And at class level, we just need to define @ mapper and mapper constant, that is Spring. So we just need to import these classes, @ mapper component model and mapping constant. We are using string value. And inside this interface, we just need to define the methods. For example, I just want to map our DTO with our entity class. So here I will just give the name employee DTO and map to employee entity. So here I will just pass employee entity as an instance. Employee entity. So this method is enough. We just need to define this method. So implementation will be generated automatically at compile time. And next we can use employee entity will be the return type, map to employee. So here we can give employee to entity. So this method will do employee to entity, and this method will convert entity to DTO. And here we just need to pass the instance of employee DTO. So here we have just defined two methods, but if we are at the time of fetch the data from database, we will get the list of employees. So if you want to convert list of employee, we need to use this method, list of employee DTO map to employee DTOs. So we can give as list of employee entity, we will get as instance list of employee entity. Employee entities, we just need to import list, so alt plus enter, so it will import this class java.util. Like this we need to add one more method if we are getting list of entity employee entity, and here we can change the name of function map to employee entities. So here we will give employee DTO list, if this will be useful, otherwise we will delete it. So here we have added four methods, so just we need to add this interface and the methods need to define here. So we can see the implementation after running this application. So let me go to our employee service implementation class, and here we need to use employee mapper class. So here what I will do, first we need to import private employee mapper and employee mapper you can use here. So here I have just auto-wired the employee mapper. So here I will use employee mapper to convert the object from one POJO into another POJO. So in the case of get all employee, we are using convert employee to entity. So here I will comment this, and here after fetching the report from DB, so here we can see after fetching the report from repository, we will just call return employee mapper dot map to employee DTOs. So here we need to pass employee entities list. After that we will get the response. So let me run our application and check the response. And here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So let me go to Postman and call the service get all employee. So here we are getting all employee list. So employee name is null for every request, employee name, 8 salary address, and we are getting 8 salary address, but employee is name is null. So let me go back to port. So here if I will go map to employee DTOs, and if you want to check the implementation of this method, so we can go and check the implementation here. So this is very simple and easy to understand. So here we can just go. So this class we have not created employee mapper implementation. This class was automatically created by map struct library that we have added. So here we can see set age, set salary and set address, these three properties are using here. Why only three fields are here? Because our three properties are just matching with same and exact name. So if I will go to employee DTO, we can see here age, salary and address is available inside employee DTO. So here we can see age, salary and address and employee name. Here are four properties. So if I will go to employee entity, so inside our employee entity we can see here is ID name, So age, salary and address exactly matching, but name is not matching because inside our DTO we have mentioned employee name. So we can see here it's employee name, and other three properties age, salary, address, three are matching exactly. So in our employee mapper implementation class that is generated by MapStruct library is generated using only these three properties, and fourth is getting null because employee name and name are not matching. So how we can set the name also in our response model if you want to show the name? So we need to go here, and here what we can do, we just need to use one annotation, @mapping. So here we can use @mapping. If we have only one property, then we can use @mapping. If we have multiple property, then we can use @mappings. So if we have multiple properties, so we can use curly braces, and inside curly braces we just need to define @mapping, and here we need to define the source. So source we can check from here, employee entity class. So our source property is name. So if I will go back, so here we just need to define name, and what is the target property? So inside employee DTO we can check the name, employee name is the target name. So if I will go back to here, and here we need to define target property, which property we are targeting. So here we can define employee name. So let me stop this application and check the response again. So here we can see we are getting null, but let me restart application and check the response again back. So I have started our application again. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So let me execute this REST endpoint again, and we'll check the employee name again. So now here we can see we are getting employee name is also, and here we can see we have 5 employee: 1, 2 Abhishek, 3 Sumit, 4 Bharat, and 5 is Chandrakant. So here we can see we have 5 employee in the list. So let me go back, and if I will go to its implementation back, so here we can see it's very easy to understand. It's employee mapper implementation class generated by MapStruct library. So here now we can see employee name is also available. So in the response we are getting these four properties now. So now let me go back to our employee service implementation, and here we can see there is only one line of code that we have used inside our employee service implementation. So we have no need to use this method now. So we can remove this method. And let me go back again, and here we can see if I will remove this. Now second method is while saving, while we need to add our employee into DB records. So we are need to convert our one POJO into second POJO. So what we will do, so here I will just call employee mapper map to entity, map to employee entity. So here we just need to pass our employee DTO. So our employee DTO will return employee entity class. So we will use this, and we can remove this code. So we will remove this code, and after getting the response from our repository, we are getting the employee entity. Then again we need to convert our entity into DTO as a response model. So we can remove this code also, and here we just call one line employee mapper map to employee DTU. So here I will just pass employee entity response and copy from here, paste it here. So we'll need to remove this also. So let me remove. So here we can see there is three lines of code only. So we have removed all the boilerplate code and we are using map struct library, and we are using the implementation code provided by map struct library. So let me save this object into DB and check the response again. So now I will call post API. So here I will call add employee. So let me add here one new employee. New employee added, and age is 22 and salary is 1800 and address is Hyderabad. So let me call and we'll check the response of this API. So here we can see new employee added and we are getting 200 OK as a response. So if I will go back and call the API get all employees again, so here we can check the response. So here is first is Lucky, second is Abhishek, third Sumit, fourth Bhar, fifth is Chandrakant, and this is the sixth employee that we have added through our post API, that is new employee added with age 22, salary 1800, Hyderabad, address. So here we can see our MapStruct library is working fine to convert our entity into another DTO class, and also working for DTO to entity and entity to DTO. So this is the main purpose of using our MapStruct library with Lombok to reduce the lines of code. Because by combining the power of MapStruct and Lombok in Spring Boot project, we can significantly simplify the mapping process, and MapStruct generates the mapping code at compile time and also reduce the manual effort and ensuring type safety also. And Lombok is also eliminate the boilerplate code, so we no need to write any setter getter or hash code methods for our model classes. So if we are using MapStruct and Lombok in our Spring Boot application, so we can just focus on our business logic, and the mapping code will be handled automatically by our MapStruct library. And this approach is also improves the code readability, maintainability and developer productivity. So that's all about our MapStruct and Lombok library. Okay, thanks for watching this video.